Hump day. Hump week. Hump month. I don't know. Sometimes it's just hard to keep on going. But here are a few strategies to get you over that hump. Hello, I'm Lisa Borowise. I am certified family health coach, weight loss advisor, and of course, creator of Mummy Shape School. And today I'm going to help you with getting over hump day, or the humps, basically. Maybe you find that once you've started any of your weight loss programs or fat loss programs, that you kind of hit a few walls or speed bumps. Maybe day three is your speed bump. Normally after day three is when you realize that you're sticking to the plan and you have to just kind of keep going through it. Maybe day three you start to notice things like detox symptoms, you know, headaches, or the cravings are just getting worse, any of those sorts of things. But what happens if you're actually in week three of the program and you're starting to see the results a little bit, but you're getting really frustrated and really impatient about what's going to happen and can you keep this momentum going? And that's what I'm going to do, is help you with three strategies that you can do right now to help you transition and get over those humps. Okay? Strategy number one is very simple. Remember why you're doing this. Sometimes it's easier to just visualize the thing at the end. Give yourself a goal, you know, whether it's, as I said, I've always said before, you know, a new dress, that does it for me, or a holiday, or a new outfit, or a new hairdo, some sort of transformative thing that you know at the end of your 5 weeks or your 6 week program that you can get and you can treat yourself with. The second thing is to really be measured along the way. Have you measured your BMI, done your before and after photographs? Because those will really motivate you as you go along. I would always suggest that maybe in and around week two or week three that you take another set of photographs just for yourself. It doesn't necessarily have to be shared with myself or other mummies in our community or anywhere, basically. It can just be for you, but you can see the progress. And when you see the progress, it's easier to keep going. It's easier to know that there's light at the end of the tunnel. And the third strategy is basically just knowing that if things are going to get better, you know, things do change, things get better. I was watching a thing last night actually on TV, a medical drama that I really like, and they were talking about this thing called the transitional period, and they were talking about it specifically to do with mummy giving birth, and I thought, wow, my mummies can really relate to this. There's a time during the birthing process where you kind of just are exhausted, you're tired, you're fed up, and you just think, what is all this for? There's no baby yet, there's nothing happening, what am I going to do? How am I going to get through this? And you know that if you just keep on focused at it, keep on going, that there is an end in sight, and it's going to be so worth it in the end. And that's what you need to do when you're feeling the hump day or the hump week. You need to transition. You need to have the mind over the body in terms of that and need to just move through it in a different sort of state in your mind. Here's hoping that those strategies help you to transition. I know that that's what helped me anytime I, you know, experienced a hump day or a hump week. So, ladies, I hope you can get through the bumps, and here's to another very successful week on a Mummy Shape School program. Beautiful hotel room. I am here in Dublin for the weekend with my part-time business. I get to have the time and financial freedom to come away and enjoy myself with other mummies just like you, enjoy the bubbles and the celebrations in the beautiful surroundings of this hotel room. If you want to change your own life, in fact, if you want to own your own life, find out a little bit more about how you can get involved, www.mummyindependenceclub.com. When you say you've had enough, and you might just give it up, oh, I will never let you down. When you're feeling low on love, I'll be what you're dreaming.